Hello friends, this is Coach Veer on my YouTube channel Coach Veer, and today we will talk about number theory and in very much detail. As you can see in the screen, I have written too many sentences and I will explain you and tell you about those sentences in details. But before that, I have a request to you. Please subscribe my channel and put a like on this video so that I get an idea. Yes, people are liking my channel. Thank you, let's start. Number theory is a very old subject in mathematics, and a mathematician named Gauss, whose pic you can see here, this Gauss said, often Prince of Mathematics, he is known as Prince of Mathematics, and he says in NCERT books also it is written that Gauss said, Queen of sciences is mathematics, and he himself considers that queen of mathematics is number theory. It's a very important and basic theory about mathematics, and it's related to pure mathematics. And very important aspect is it that in Olympiad questions or any other entrance exams, questions related to this are usually asked, but they are of very low level, means they are among the easiest question in the number theory, and if we know the basics, we can easily solve them. So first let me tell you what is number theory all about. It is a very vast higher mathematics. People generally say is as arithmetic only, but in terms of higher studies, it's higher arithmetic. It usually consists of whole numbers, natural numbers, primes, prime factorization, and very important about functions such as divisor function, Euclid Lima you might have done, and Riemann zeta function, a very important kind of function which if you say I will explain in another video because it is a very large topic, and totient functions like that type of functions, psi function, divisor function, coprime functions, number of divisor functions, like that type of functions are defined in number theory. And it's very important aspect to know about the structure of numbers. So let's talk from the basic. I know you know, but few of them might be knowing or not knowing. Let's start from the basic. I will tell you each and every aspect of the numbers. Okay, now from the basic, if we will start, the biggest platform which we get on the numbers is what type of number? I think it is the complex number, the biggest set of numbers, complex numbers or imaginary numbers, which are denoted with the letter Z usually, and in the form of A plus IB, where A and B both belongs to integers. Okay, these both are the real numbers, or they belongs to real numbers also. You can put it like this also, it's better to write it this way. They both are the real numbers, but this part A is known as the real part, whereas this part with the I value means root over negative 1, this part is known as imaginary part. So both A and B are real numbers, but this is real part and this part is the imaginary part of the complex number. Okay, that's the important, and it is the biggest number set which we use. Sorry for my handwriting, it's very poor, I know. Okay, let's talk about numbers which are inside it. Inside it, another number set is there, which is the real number sets. And real number set is denoted with capital letter R, or you can say printed letter R. And it's all the numbers which are represented on the number line. These all numbers are the real numbers. Okay, from minus infinity to infinity, and this whole real number set is contained in this. How, if somebody has doubt, so you can write a real number Z is equal to A plus 0 I, It means this imaginary part is 0 and A is the real number. Okay, so these contain in this, and if something extra comes with the multiple of I other than 0, then it will become a complex number, not a real number. In the real number also, we have division, like two types of numbers. What are those two types of numbers? That I will explain to you. First number is your irrational number and rational number. So usually rational numbers and irrational numbers. What is rational number and what is denotation? Its denotation is Q. And what's the denotation of irrational number? You might not have seen. Why? Because we have an intelligent idea that R minus Q is irrational number. These are all sets. Set is like a bag in mathematics, which have collection of elements. Maybe that collection is of any number, function or anything, but it must be a defined element collection, not a abrupt or arbitrary. It must be defined. Okay, let's talk about rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are both, P and Q both are integers. Okay, and Q should not be equal to 0. That's also important in this case. Otherwise it will be infinity. So you need to know that it is denotation with the Q. Okay, now in the rational numbers like 2 by 3, 4 by 3, these are the rational number. But one of my student said, what's irrational numbers? I know some of them might be knowing pi, root over 2, root over 3, root over 5, root over 7, like that, and e also, Euler number. But here comes another number, another irrational number, which is quite familiar with the society. What's that? It's phi. I said phi, it is a Greek alphabet. How can, what number it is? So he said it is golden ratio, sir, 1.16, like that. It keeps on going. I said, yeah, that's a golden ratio number, and I know 1.618 is the approximation of it, but it will keep on happening like that. Okay, it's a irrational number, nice number. There is a Fibonacci series relation with that, and it's a little bit bigger things to explain here. So, okay, let's forget about this for a while and talk about the rational numbers. Rational numbers are 2 by 3, 2, 1, anything. But what's inside that? Inside rational numbers, we have integers. Okay, what's that integer means? Integer means Z. Z is a letter from the German word Zahlen. Zahlen in German, it means number. That's why it's not I, it's Z for integers. Okay. Keep in mind, integers are denoted with Z, and these are all from 0, 1, minus 1, like that they are. Inside the integer, there are still whole numbers. Whole numbers means with the 0, if you have, like in a set notation, I am writing 0, 1, 2, like that, so we have a whole number. And inside that integer and whole number, we have the natural numbers. Natural number is denoted with N, and it's 1, 2, like that, and they are infinite. But here one thing you need to understand, in mathematics there is a word, a specific word, countable set and uncountable set. What is a countable set? In mathematics, both natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, these are all countables. But why rational and irrational number, real number, are they uncountable? Yes, they are uncountable. In mathematics, natural number is countable. It is equal to alpha null and like that. But they are transfinite numbers. But what about the basic about finding a thing countable or uncountable? If the function is defined for natural number sequences, then that thing can be said as countable in mathematics, otherwise uncountable. Okay, let's move back to the another thing. Hope this basic is clear. I just want to emphasize on this because I don't want to leave this topic unattended. Now let's get back and let's move further. Let's talk about prime and composite numbers. A prime is an integer which is n greater than 1. So better you need to understand n value should be always greater than 1, not equal to 1, and it's only a positive. Okay, positive divisors means it n should be positive, as this is greater than 1, so it is to be positive, and its positive divisors are n and 1 or 1 and n. Then if positive divisors of n are 1 and n itself, then it is a prime number, otherwise it is a composite number. Or if it is not a prime, it is composite, but it's not the case with the 1. 1 is neither a prime number nor a composite number. Or don't talk about the negatives also. Okay, as we are talking with the positive numbers. Okay, here are first few prime numbers like 2. 2 is the only even prime number, because if any other even number will come after that, it is divisible by 2. That's why 2 is the only even prime number. That is an important thing to know about prime number, and very much fascinating. You can see 3, 5, 7, 11, and other than that 4, 6, 8, those who are factored by another prime numbers, or prime factorization is possible for them, that are the composite ones. Here a very much contradiction is there, whether this prime number is just like a weed in the garden of natural number, these are the weed, or whether they follow a military precision procedure to erupt. Like they are coming 41, 43, the distance is different from each of them. I don't know whether they are same or not. It's very peculiar behavior, but some says it is very much systematic. They follow a systematic procedure, but we don't know it. Till the time Riemann zeta hypothesis, Riemann hypothesis, if you are able to understand, then you can think about this fact, that whether they are a weed or actually they have a very specific procedure to erupt in between the natural numbers. Hope this is quite complicated, but yeah, it's true. Let's move further, friends, and you see here in the next fundamental theorem of arithmetic. What the fundamental theorem of arithmetic says? Fundamental theorem of arithmetic says that every natural number can be written as product of prime uniquely up to a order, up to order. It means, in normal words, you have a natural number, you can write it as prime factors, like 4, you can write it as 2 into 2, into 1 is not required because 1 is not prime, okay. Every natural number is a product of primes, whether it is a prime itself, it is a product of prime, okay, or prime square. They have a special meaning in number theory, prime square, things like that type of stuff. Okay, hope you understood this. This is a very basic, but it's important from the fundamental point of view, and it will gonna help us in solving further. Let's see how. Next important thing I want to talk about is greatest common divisor, GCD. We usually do SCF also in our school, highest common factor. These all things are same, don't worry about them. But GCD, we talk usually about the numbers, specifically about numbers. Now, denotation, all over the world, the denotation is like this. In a standard book, you will find a denotation like this, small GCD and bracket A and B. A and B are the both two numbers of which we want to find the GCD. You might say 3, 4, like that you can write, not an issue. But let's talk about 2 only. So what's that function? What's GCD? GCD means maximum value of that D which divides see how to read this. D divides A means if you have 3, you need to know it is to be like that, not like this. This is wrong. 9 does not divide 3. 3 divides 9. So in mathematical community, in books, you usually read it as D divides A and D divides B. So if D is dividing A and D is dividing B and it is a maximum number, maximum integer, then it is the GCD of both A and B. But there is an abstract here. A and B are 0. Unless both A and B are 0, in that case GCD of 0 and 0 is just 0. Okay, defined a convention like 0 factorial we consider as 1. A convention we made like for the current positive to negative conventions. Okay, to simplify, like whole mathematics is based on axioms. If you change the axioms, mathematics is changed totally. Okay, let's talk about, for example, GCD of 1 and 2 is 1. You can see if a kid might be saying, okay, 1 is equal to 1, 2 is equal to 2 into 2, 1 is the biggest factor, so it is 1. I say correct. Let's talk about 6. You will say 2 into 3 and 27 is 3 into 3 into 3, or you can say 3 to the power 3, so 3 is the GCD. I said fine. Why I am saying that, I will gonna tell you after this. Don't worry, a big thing is coming. Okay, GCD of 0 and A, and A and 0 is both equal to A. Why? Because if you have a number 2, will it gonna divide 0? What? 0 divided by 2 is equal to infinite. Okay, don't make it more complicated for both of us. Let's move further. Just understand this. GCD of any number with the 0 is 1, that number. Why? Because you can take out anything from 0. 0 you can write as 0 into A, and then you will write A, and then you will say A is the common factor. Simple. Okay, let's move further. For any integer A and B, we have GCD. Very important theorem. Please note it down if you have a pen and pencil. It's very important from the exam point of view if you get these type of questions related to GCD. So GCD of A and B is same as GCD of B and A. GCD of plus minus AB, both the things are going to be same. Whether you change the symbol or not, it's going to be same. Same way, GCD of A comma B minus A is same as GCD of A comma B plus A. Whether you add A or subtract it, it's going to be same. Next thing, important thing which I have is this. GCD of A comma B minus NA or GCD of A comma B plus NA is same as GCD of AB, where N is just a natural number, or any integer also, it's up to you. Because if it is an integer, plus and minus is not required. You can just put negative. I have put it both plus and minus as I have defined it as a natural number. Okay, don't put it zero. Otherwise, it's just A and B. Okay, so how to utilize this formula? Suppose I said you GCD of 2, 8. You said, sir, 2, very easy. I said, okay, GCD of, let's make it bigger than what you think, 1, 2, 0, 9, 7, 8, 4. I think it's pretty big for find GCD. Big. How will you solve that? You need to utilize this funda that you can subtract n times a from b and make it small. Okay, let's do that. But how? Which n we should? You just do like that. If you do prime factorization doing LSM, that's a very big thing. Don't do. I suggest you. Okay, so let's talk about 12 or 120. Let's make it 120. When you divide it with it, so I think 8 is fine. 0, 8 to the 16 and 1 on the top. 8 ones are 8 and 9. And 1, I am doing it pretty slow. I am not good at calculation, but I am good at maths. See the melancholy. Okay, let's do one more time with 120. It's going to be 4 and 6. Okay, so you might be wondering, we get 64. So it's the fact. Let's do a simple arithmetic here. I can write this as 9784 minus 81 times 120, and it's same as the GCD of 120 times 64. And wow, it's now little bit easier than what we can do. And if you want further, if you want, you can subtract GCD of 64. You can subtract from him. If you subtract 64 from him, you are going to get 56, and this is again 64. Oh no, I want to do it further. Really? Let's do it further. What we can do further? Let's subtract 56 from him. Oh ho, okay, let's do that. And if we do 64, 56 will remain 56, and we will subtract this from this, we are going to get 8. You need further. 8 8s are 64, 8 7s are 56. I think 8 is the answer. Okay, so GCD of that is 8. 8 is our answer. Okay, let's try this, and you can find out that 8 divides both of them. It's quite easy, you can do that. But see how it is made easier for all of you. And you can try other few questions like this. GCD of 498 and 1784, and tell the answer in the comment. I will check your answer. Okay, thank you for watching this video. If you have further doubts about this thing, and I have more things to tell you about this, it's not this. After that, I want to start with modulo arithmetics, Chinese remainder theorems, total end functions, even groups and rings if you want in the abstract algebra portion. That's kind of very good stuff in mathematics, which I think it is a good stuff. So let's stop our lesson here with the number theory lesson, and it's related to pure mathematics. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and like this video. It's important for me, really. I am saying it from the heart. You can understand. And okay, see you in my next video, friends. Bye for now.